everyone, this is Shane here with RVs of America. I got a pretty exciting video to share with you today. This is going to be a long one. It's going to be a tour of a brand new Black Series. This is a 2020 HQ19. We are outside, we're up in the mountains, it's a little windy, so sorry if you hear that wind. But before I get onto this tour, I just wanted to remind you, we are the premier Black Series dealer in the United States of America and in Canada. There's not one in Canada. So if you guys are looking, if you're seriously interested in buying a Black Series, RVs of America is the main place to go to in the US. We're located over in Utah. We know these trailers more than anybody else. We use these trailers more than anybody else. We modify them. So, and as far as a customer buying experience, nobody else is going to come even close to what we can offer you as an owner of Black Series. So without anything else, I am going to start this tour. And I do want to mention to you that this tour, this is going to be more focused on features. I'm going to try to update you on some of the new components and the new features in the 2020 from the 2019. And I'm going to just go into as much detail about the features of it. This isn't a user manual or a how-to guide. If you are interested in buying a Black Series, when you become a customer of RVs of America out of Utah, we will send you a exclusive library of videos, and that goes more into detail, user manual, technical support. We have a lot of after the purchase support that we do for our customers. So that's not what this video is. This isn't going to show you how things work. It's going to be more focused on the unit itself, the product, how it's built, etc. So without anything else, let's get started here. Here we are. One of the coolest things about the Black Series that's so unique to them that you don't see in anything else is the suspension, right?
Whoa.
Let's take a look down at the suspension. It is absolutely incredible. The suspension is, so it's on, there's two gas shocks per control arm. Those control arms are load tested at 40,000 pounds per control arm, so it's like absurd, you know, they shouldn't break. You got like 160,000 pounds. Obviously that's way overkill, but two gas shocks per control arm, so a total of 8 gas shocks coils. You do have electric drum brakes. They're 12-inch drum brakes, very good. 4 of them. You have all 4 wheels with brakes, which is really nice. This is not a standard trailer. Most standard trailers have a torsion axle, you know, that bar that is coming across the center of the thing, which if you're off-road and you're going to smash or bend, and then also you have leaf springs. So most trailers are sitting on essentially pieces of metal on a bar, right? And that's what's going to destroy your trailer over time, is because, you know, opposed to, you know, this is the independent suspension. If you've ever driven an old one-ton truck with leaf springs and torsion axles, it's super stiff and rough. And so people don't realize it's, I think it's funny, you know, in the US, some of these new manufacturers are starting to say, oh, we have an off-road trailer. And all they do is they take that axle and they take those leaf springs, and instead of going underneath, they flip it and they put them on top, and then it's lifted, and then they put big tires on it, and they're like, it's off-road. And it's like, that is not off-road. All that is they lift it up, you know, pavement trailer, you know, a trailer that should not go off-road, should stick to campgrounds. Now you've just made it higher, and now it has a worse center of gravity, and it's still gonna fall apart and rattle just as much as on or off. I mean, it's so, that's not off-road. I always think that's hilarious. And then also the hitch, I'll get to the hitch in a second. That is also a huge problem with taking most trailers off-road, is the actual hitch setup. But now I'm gonna talk about your tires. These, the stock tires that come on the brand new ones is 265/75. It's a 16-inch rim, nice alloy rims, which is nice. They look good. Obviously on the 19, you have 4 of them. Now, something back here, since we're in the back, let's talk first about an update that Black Series has done. And if you kind of come back down low again, you're going to see that they've rearranged the tanks. The tanks used to be in a different direction. They've also added insulation to all the plumbing, which is nice. There's also an insulation under the subfloor, which is very nice. So more and more insulation. They've beefed up the insulation.
But right up here, come back over here. This is super nice. What they've done is they've added the black tank and the gray tank drain valves right here in the back. On the previous models, you had the black tank in the back, but the gray tank was up in the front. They were separate outlets. You had to essentially dump your tanks, and then you had to move the trailer and dump your other tank. It was very inconvenient. Here in the 2020 model, they've brought it together and have put them right next to each other. Also, they have added a lot of insulation. There's a lot more insulation. Now, a lot of people may be asking, well, what's in the walls? What's in the roof? There is insulation in the walls and the roof. I have a video where I talk about the truth of four seasons and RV insulation. I don't even like to quote what manufacturers say is their R value because I don't agree with most of them. I think they're a little bit inaccurate. And the reason why is because there's nobody that actually is out testing them and like actually rating it and then, you know, stamping the approval. Yeah, that is your R value. But it does have insulation in the walls. It does have insulation in the roof. I've been camping in this trailer and the Black Series trailers more in freezing temperatures than in warm, and they do fine. Dual pane windows too, so that's a really huge thing. That's super nice. Now, coming over to here, if you're new to this channel and you haven't seen these videos, I just want to welcome you and let you know, like, this is the best trailer in America in my opinion. There's not a better trailer out there that you can buy. But let me show you. So right here we have our bash bars, right? I mean, these things aren't going to necessarily you know, hold the trailer up if you fall on it. Hopefully you're not falling. It's because you've got almost 26 inches of clearance from the ground to these bars, which is crazy high. So hopefully you're not actually needing to fall on this. But we did have there was a customer recently that brought his trailer in, and he was pulling out of the gas station, and he ran into one of the cinder block guardrails, and he smashed the bar and didn't smash the wall, which is super nice. So it did, and it's a lot cheaper to replace his bar than it is to try to repair the trailer itself. So now you do have 4-point stabilization. This guy right there comes out, drops down, and you have this on all four corners of the trailer, which is super nice. This is for stability. Stability to, so you're not rocking so much. Moving right over to here, we have our recovery hooks, D-rings. These are rated for 9,000 pounds each. And you have two of them on each side, so you could essentially, if you got yourself in a bad situation, you could tow yourself out backwards, you could tow somebody else. Hopefully you don't get in that type of situation. One of the things that I wanted to point under the trailer again is the actual tank itself. As you can see, it has a diamond plating and these nice bars that are holding everything up. Really nice. I mean, I've seen trailers holding their tanks up by straps, essentially. It's crazy. So very, very robust. And we've taken these off-roading where we've actually hit the tanks, and the tanks were protected. Total length of the trailer is 26 feet 3 inches. I know it's called the HQ19. Model numbers never mean anything on a trailer. That's just, sorry, that's the way it is. You do have, it is about, so from the tip of the tire all the way to the tip of the hitch is 26 foot 3 inches. So if you have a garage that's 26 feet, it will not fit inside of it. We have a bunch of measurements on our website, so don't forget, it's rvsofamerica.com. Go to the ad, scroll to the bottom. We have like 60 photos of us measuring everything on the website. So you can definitely go there. Now, over here, I want to point out, you have some outside speakers. These are marine grade speakers. It's nice for music. It also works off the radio, which is inside, and it's Bluetooth. You have a nice little shore power plug right there. You also have a 12 volt plug right here, and that's what we use that for, is when we're airing down the tires. If we're off-roading, we use that to air up the tires with a pump with a 12 volt plug. So before we head over this way, let's come back here, and I just wanted to show you, there is a little tray that drops down, which is super nice for prepping food or finished food. You could also put a 12 volt, some stuff out here, charge things, if you're a tailgater, throw your TV or whatever, I don't know. So just some extra space there. This is a little solar light, works, it's off a solar power urn, it's a sensor, so it turns on at night when you're coming in. Before I open this, I want to talk a little bit about the windows. The windows are nice. They are dual pane windows, which a lot of people don't realize on most travel trailers. That's not an option you get. So for cold weather, you know, dual pane, I mean, you're going to lose all your, you know, temperature out of the windows before anything else. I mean, if you've ever lived in an old house with single pane windows, you feel the cold coming in. So the dual pane windows is a big deal. These are also a polycarbonate. It's a Eurovision is the company that makes it. And polycarbonate in the same diameter from what I've read is 30 times stronger than glass. So it is strong, it's durable. We have a video of us throwing baseballs at it. We did that at a show for fun. Had a baseball sitting around so we could let people throw baseballs at it. So it is super cool. But this is one of the coolest things about Black Series is this incredible kitchen. This comes all the way out here. There is a leg that goes down, gives it more support. You also have this nice prep area where you can put stuff, and this comes up to protect the wind, and it's propane. You have quick disconnects that pop in. I'm not going to show how all that works. We have that in our customers' videos. We show you how to hook things up. And you also have water, so you have water on demand. Nice little area where you could be washing and putting things down here. And you also have an electric igniter. And so you don't actually have to use a striker. You could use this is a Dometic product, super nice. But lots of storage space. And if you're out cooking, putting stuff here, you can throw stuff over onto the table right here, the finished product with your, you know, I don't know, whatever you're cooking, hamburgers, and put the buns and condiments over there. But yeah, then you close this up, put this in, and shut it up. So super nice. Very, very solid filling too. It is freezing here. If you can hear the wind, it's going, it's freezing. One of the updates actually that I didn't point out yet is this leg. This is the new leg for the kitchens for the 2020 models. It used to be this little triangle deal, and you had to like tighten a butterfly screw, and usually you needed like some pliers to tighten it. This right here is just a handle, and it tightens hand tight, and it adjusts up and down. Super, super nice little addition. So I really, really like that. Now, some of the construction material, which I haven't mentioned yet, is this is an aluminum sheeting right here. And this right here is an aluminum composite. So you can see that along the entire trailer. You have this, this is a diamond plated. It's a European style, but it's aluminum right here. And then this is an aluminum sheeting. These are decals. So, you know, I would expect, you know, this might be the first thing you end up having to fix in your trailer in 5 or so years. But as far as like aluminum sheeting goes, you know, people always ask me the question, well, how long will this trailer last? And I'm like, well, there's so many variables. Are you going to have it parked inside? Are you going to have it outside? You know, it's hard to answer that type of question out there. But I always think, well, let's compare it with product, you know, like, what is on most trailers versus what is this, you know? Most trailers are gonna use a fiberglass that they adhere or glue to to wood or sheet, like slats and stuff. And those tend to delaminate and crack, and lots of bad stuff happen to it. Now, aluminum, well, I think it takes 200 to 500 years for aluminum to decomposite. So, I mean, the paint might peel before then, but the actual aluminum itself it's going to outlive you, you know? So very, very durable. Now, if you've watched any of my videos, I'm going to assume you haven't and you're new here. One of the things I like to point out is these luggage lock racks that are just unbelievable. These are awesome. These are super heavy duty. These are what we see in Monaco diesel pushers, $500,000 motorhomes. We're at the RV show, and our booth was right next to a $125,000 trailer. Had $2 latches, these like butterfly latches, and I'm just like, what? Like, why? Like I understand that being on a $15,000 or $20,000 trailer, but why on a $125,000 trailer do you put two? I mean, these are nice. These are $25. So if you're wondering why the trailers are more expensive than a cheap $20,000 trailer, piano hinges, you know, dual gas struts. I mean, it's just like, it doesn't just end there. It continues. Aluminum, the cost of aluminum versus, you know, fiberglass or paneling is like, last time I checked, I think it was 20 to 30 times more expensive for the same size piece, right? So it's just more expensive materials when they're building the trailer. Over here, as you can see, we got our propane set up, you know, opposed to most trailers you see in America are sitting on a platform in a plastic box. So as you can see, this is super nice. You have, these are mounted. I mean, you can see these L bracket pieces of steel that are mounted in here to the floor. You know, this pops out right here, latches in, and this is super nice. They have these rubber things right here that are actually going to hold it from banging around. It's mounted up against the wall here, which is super nice, and you have your valves right here. You can adjust from one side to the other side. Now, as you can see, there's I put in a larger tank in here. Now, this is what they come with stock. This is a 20 pounder. You know, you can easily fit in a 30 pound propane tank in here. That's just why I put that in there, so you could get an example and see what it looks like. But yeah, you can adjust that and you ratchet it in. And when we're at shows, I always tell people, tug on this, you know, and you just, when you tug on it, you just feel how sturdy and strong it is. Really, really cool. So now I'm gonna walk around to the other side and show you from the back, working my way forward. Now we've worked back around to the other side here, and I wanna work my way back up to the tongue. Wanted to point out something new on the 2020s, you have a city water connection. So you can, when you go to a campground, if you do go to a campground, which these trailers can go to campgrounds, they're not only off-road trailers. Lots of people tell us, man, you guys go crazy off-road. I don't want to do that. And I'm like, well, listen, this trailer is built better than anything out there. You know, when people spend $20,000 or $30,000 more for, like, say, an Airstream that's, you know, the same quality as this, and they don't go off-roading, is because they're designed, they're so low to the ground, they're not designed to go anywhere but to a campground. So you know, it's not just an off-road rig, this is just a better built quality trailer. And so if you're not like going crazy, now we do have the setup where, you know, these are kind of more so built originally for off-grid use, but you do now have a city outlet hookup. Now I want to talk a little bit about this drinking and general water. As you can see, there's two fill stations on this. I'm going to talk more about this on the inside and point something out to you. Super, super cool. So these trailers have two separate water tanks. Oh, and also on the other side, which I forgot to show you. I forgot to point this out earlier, but it does actually have a black water tank flush. What this is for is when you go to an actual dump station and you're dumping your black, you know, your sewage from your toilet, you stick a hose into here and it flushes out the water. Now back over here, working our way down, we have another 12 volt plug right here. Like I said, we use a pump to air up your tires if you need to. So, you know, it's always good, it's always best practice to air up your tires, always check your tire pressure, always check your lug nuts, especially after off-roading. You never want to be over-torqued, under-torqued, and you always want to make sure you're right pressure. Now, right here, this is pretty cool. This is an outside shower, and this does do hot or cold water, and you can, if you wanted to, they have some of those shower things set up that you could put out here to give you, like, an outside shower. Or you can spray off the dogs, the kids, whatever. Over here, we have our exhaust. We have our water heater. It's a 6-gallon quick recovery propane water heater. This is your 30 amp plug. And then right over here, I'm gonna open this up and show you the inside. We'll have to insert a video of what most trailers you see in these. This is a residential breaker panel. Super nice, right? It's not super cheesy and cheap. You also do have a light in here, which is nice, so lights up if it's dark.
But
most trailers, you know, they have this plastic box and they put these things in there. I've literally seen these melt. I wish I had some pictures of them melted, but it's crazy. So this is like residential grade. This is what you're going to see in your house. So very, very nice. But now coming back up here to the front of the trailer, we're back up to the tongue. I mentioned earlier something about the hitch. And I say it's so funny how, you know, some of the manufacturers kind of do this, you know, we have an off-road trailer, right? And then you have a ball hitch. Now, a ball hitch only has certain movements, right? It can only move so far. So if you're off-roading, yeah, heck, if you're coming out of a gas station, right? You know, and you get into a weird, or up a hill and you get into a weird spot where your ball, it gets, you know, it can get to the point where it can't move anymore and it could either eject, brake, snap. You know, I've seen trailers get unhooked before. It's not uncommon, especially if you're going off-roading extreme type of stuff. So without replacing a hitch, I don't feel like any trailer could be called off-road. So if you're running the standard ball, your trailer's not off-road. This is what's called the poly block, and it actually moves like kind of like in 90 degrees in every angle. We'll show you some footage of this stuff, but this guy right here, this moves into every degree this way. It moves over 90 degrees this way. It goes up and down for washes, and it's incredible. You know, you got to have a good hitch, right? Now, I'm going to, over here, another cool thing is we have a brake, right? Opposed to having to chalk your wheels or throw blocks or rocks under there, you can actually just brake it, which is super nice. Over here, we have a plug. This is an Anderson connection. Now, the trailer comes stock with 300 watts of solar, but if you wanted to, you could get a briefcase, you know, on Amazon with this actual connector, and you could add an additional panel outside and have it set up if you felt that 300 was not enough. Most trailers get zero, right? So 300 is pretty good. Also, that you could use that pin to plug into the truck and also use your truck as a charging system to charge up your batteries. Now, this is cool. This is your jack, your tongue jack. This is what lifts the trailer off of the vehicle. What's really cool about this is it moves in a lot of different directions, but the concept behind this still is you pull this out right here. This swivels down and you can disconnect. And if you got into a crazy situation, you could use this wheel to essentially roll the trailer around. You know, you'd want it in the down position. But so that's a super cool thing right there. You gotta be careful that you never overextend these jacks. Right over here, this is an extra 4 millimeter thickness. This is an extra weld plate. Underneath the frame of this trailer, there's tons and tons of extra supports. Now remember, Black Series comes with a 5-year chassis warranty. Or as those Australians call it, is a chassis, I think is what they say. Another update to the 2020 models is this plate right here comes out and it has a little bit like a wing, and these are actually drilled in and bolted right here. This used to be melted or welded directly to the frame. I think this is going to be way more safe ultimately in the end. And this is 3 times thicker than what's required in the United States. These chains are ginormous. And then it does run a 7-pin connector, which is the standard US. Most trucks have that stock. If they don't, you just install it pretty easily. And that runs your brakes, your lights, and everything else. And this is another storage compartment. It is super deep, or super tall, I should say. So you can put some tall stuff up in there, which is really nice. Also, you have a... this is a jerry can holder, 2 bolts. If you wanted to remove that, you could, and have more just storage in here. This, you can actually fit a 2000 watt Honda generator sideways or the horizontal, however you want in here, which is super nice and convenient. We actually have a cool mod that you can run the air conditioning with a 2000 watt Honda generator. But we have, like I said earlier, we're pretty much the only ones in America that actually use and modify these. There's nobody else that's really doing that as far as a dealership goes. So if there's things that you want upgraded or changed or improved, you know, we're talking with a guy from Alaska the other day, and he's like, I want the best winter package. So we're gonna go crazy. I mean, we already do a really good one, but he wants us to, I mean, he's like talking below 30 degree type of temperature. So we're gonna work on that. So we're willing to really dive into anything, and that's what we do. So, but we're gonna head back over to the other side. It is freezing. I think it's like 10 degrees out here. We're gonna head inside where it's nice and warm and do the inside tour. Come on. This is what we love about the Black Series, is because you can go to places that no other trailer can take you. This is incredible. I mean, some trailers could get you up here, but we've gone to places where no other trailer can get you. It's pretty incredible. But it's so cold. I checked the temperature before coming up into the canyon, and it was like 20 degrees, close to 20 degrees today. And so it's probably in the single digits right now. But before I let all the heat out, I want to explain this door. This is a super cool door. It has an incredible screen. This thing comes up here and it actually separates and holds the door. This right here goes back and holds the door. You don't need to see it. It just kind of, so you get the idea. Now you have a nice screen door. This is incredible. Super strong. It also has this point right here, and you have a center point and you have a bottom point. So you can see how this goes up in and out and locks. The reason why you want this is when you're off-roading. I have, from experience, taken my parents' trailer up into the mountains, and you're taking these sharp turns. This is on pavement, right? And the trailer is twisting, right, and bending. And the door kept on popping open because it only has one spot right here. Now, when you're going off-roading, you want it to lock at multiple points so the trailer doesn't pop open, which is really incredible. We've had this trailer at an over 20 degrees camber, and the door still opened and shut just fine. A cool new feature I want to point out in the 2020 models. As you can see, this light right here, it used to be enclosed in something that lots of people would kick and break. They've actually recessed it underneath this metal, and it also has a sensor. So when you shut the door, it turns off, which is super cool. So you can leave the light on, and if you're out and you come back in the night, you open it up, it will automatically turn the light on. So that's a super nice thing. And now here you have your steps that come out, and let's go on inside. I am so freezing. Welcome on inside. It is much warmer in here. It was freezing outside. I was freezing. Now I'm not even wearing shoes. I'm probably gonna have to take off my jacket soon because it's nice and toasty in here. We're probably sitting at single digits right now. And as you can see, I have an incredible view here. I don't know who doesn't like the Black Series. These trailers are beautiful. The only people that I've actually heard really say too many negative things about them are people that have never seen them. They're just like on a forum or somewhere, you know, that have not actually seen one in person. Because I've been in the business of selling trailers for over a decade, right? And the most common thing I feel like, you know, I've sold a lot of used trailers is, you know, you have a nice camera, you take pictures of the trailer, and people are always like, man, like the pictures are deceiving. Like, usually it's like the pictures make it look nicer. I have not heard anybody say that about the Black Series. People that actually see them in person are like the trailers are, like the pictures don't do it justice and the videos don't do it justice. Like, they're nicer in person. I mean, everything about them, like, this is like, I mean, they're just so solid. So I, anyway, and what's so cool about them is, you know, when we go to shows, it's the everybody talks about them, right? People just rave about them. And the cool thing is the outside of it, they save marriages. I don't know if you know that, you know, so we're doing good in the world with Black Series because the men just love the outside of them. And the inside is like this luxurious, you know, beautiful finishes, you know? So let me talk about some of the features now. Sorry for the ramble, but let's start with the wood, right? It's a Malaysian timber. It does have a high gloss veneer finish, which is super nice. It is a honeycomb, so that's a hollow center, so kind of like a door if you ever see in your house, and they do that for weight purposes. A lot of people complain about the weight of the trailer because it is pretty heavy. It weighs about 5,800 pounds, 6,800 pounds, 1,000 pounds heavier, right? Not a big deal. So most typical people buying this trailer are buying it with a 3/4 ton is ideal, you know. We have a lot of people buying them with half tons too, and it's doable with the weight distribution hitch and stuff, but whatever, you know. That's kind of, I prefer a 3/4 or bigger. So as you can see, nice wood finishes. Now the walls themselves, this right here, the wall right here, this is an aluminum composite material. And one of the updates in the 2020s versus the 2019s is right up here. They've changed out the ceilings with the same materials that they build the walls with, which is an aluminum composite material. I think that's a huge, 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 huge deal. Previously was a lamination and there was some issues with it. Some people were having, so this is, we've not had any issues with the walls. And I have a trailer that's on my lot that's almost 2 to 3 years old. It's in great condition still. So haven't had any problems with the aluminum composite yet. So that's what they've replaced the ceiling in the 2020s. And to me, I think that's one of the biggest and most important improvements that they've made. They've also, another thing on the top of the actual trailer itself is it also, they've switched it from a fiberglass to a one-piece aluminum. There used to be a seam. And then also they've added it, it's all aluminum. So now, I mean, essentially, it's like an Airstream, right? It's all aluminum. The roof, the walls, the inside, the outside. The actual frame itself, I don't think I mentioned this, but it's an RHS. That's a rectangular hollow stud aluminum, and it's all welded. So very, very important. A lot of trailers are stick built with wood, and they're stapled, right? Not welded, right? Obviously. And so when you're off-roading and rattling, things just come apart, you know. So you cannot flip the axle and call yourself an off-roader if you're stapled wood together. That's like a big no-no. So that's big improvements in the 2020s from the 2019s. So huge, huge right there. Another thing that they've improved is they've upgraded the blinds. This is more of an accordion type of style blind. The last year's 2019s, they were flat. So they kind of, and they did tend to sometimes get crinkled up in the tracks. And also same thing with the screen. So, and these are really cool features about the Black Series is they have this nice screen and then also the blackout shade. And then you also have these curtains that come down. And that's super nice, and that closes out a lot of light. Makes it, this trailer is very dark in it at night. And then also you have these windows are incredible. Every single one of them opens up. That's to the first position. You can go up one more, and then you have a nice position. You can even go higher, and lots of airflow. Very, very nice. Tons of lighting. The windows by the bed are ginormous. I'll show you in a second. And then you can put the screen up, get lots of airflow during the summer. But super nice. And then you just lift that up and let it drop back down. Really, really nice. These lights right here, these are a marine light, which is super nice. Type of light you see in a yacht. It turns off, it has a night light, that little blue light that turns on, and then you can click it again and it turns on the light, and then if you click and hold it,
it will get brighter, and if you do it again, it will get dimmer. So you can actually have a nice dim reading light. These are super low voltage or wattage, but they're pretty bright. So it's really nice for trying to conserve battery. Now this is a very nice, all of the leather, this is actually a synthetic leather. It's a marine type of leather. So it's nice because it washes easy. Real leather stains really badly, and it's hard to, you don't want to wash it with certain materials. So this you can wipe off with a sponge. But it's very nice feeling, very quality. You can see along the edges over here, it's all the double stitching, and you have that diamond pattern. I've talked with some upholstery people, and they have said this feels very quality. Behind the bedboard, the headboard, you can see how they've put that nice diamond plating all the way throughout. Over here, you have a nice little area up there and little storage pockets. Same with along the door here. You can put your little emergency stuff, flashlights and stuff in there. That's what we do. Over here, you have nice light switches. Right here, these are your inside lights. These are your outside LED bars on all four corners. And then this is your master switch. Once again, another reading light. Now, if you back up a little bit and you can kind of see over the head, you have these main lights first, and then you have these lights. This is the lights actually above the bed, right there. And over here, step over here, you have another two-way that does the ones above the bed, which is super nice. Lots of lighting all the way throughout. This is nice storage. This is where you can hang up clothing. I'll go on the other side over there. And it's super deep. So my wife uses these like zipper travel bags, and we put our underwear and shorts and stuff like that, socks down below, and then you can still hang up shirts above. You can hang up like 10 to 15 shirts. Somebody was complaining about, there's nowhere to hang up shirts. And I'm like, how many shirts do you need? I need 7, one for each day of the week, right? And then I do my laundry. You can stuff a good amount of, there's always, it's never going to make everybody happy. You know, it's just like I always say, in the golden age, I'm sure there were people that complained about how everything was too yellow, right? It's like, and everybody's not always going to be pleased, but you do have a good amount of storage. You have the storage up here. You do have some little storage up over here. And then also on the other side, there's some more storage. My wife usually uses this side because, you know, this has more storage. This has a little bit of storage up here, but you have also your plugs and antennas for your TV and everything. But you do have a good amount of storage. Now back over here, you have some nice little storage here. I like usually throw keys in my wallet. Now you know. Down here, there is a huge storage compartment down here. This is super tall and super deep. You could put boots, pots and pans. I don't know what, probably boots, because pots and pans will go in the kitchen area. But yeah, so you could put that's a pretty big compartment. Another update from the 2019s to the 2020s is they're using this nicer mattress. This is like a memory foam type of mattress, so always improving things. Over here, look at this. I love this grab handle, right? This is a really solid metal grab handle. It's amazing. We've had one of these in our HQ12. That we have had for more than a year, going on 2 years now, and we've taken that thing to shows, and thousands of people have walked in grabbing, pulling themselves up, and that thing hasn't broken, which is incredible. You see most trailers, they have this cheesy little plastic handle, you know, super nice. It just feels so good. It feels really good quality. I mean, everything about it feels really, really good. I mean, it's not perfect. Don't get me wrong. For those who have never owned a trailer, trailers are not perfect. You know, every time you take them camping, you go, especially if you go off-roading, you know, things are going to break, right? Nothing's perfect. I always tell people, don't forget, you know, the smartest scientists in the world have built space shuttles, you know, that cost billions of dollars, that have blown up the first time they were used or launched into the air. So anything man-made, you know, can break, you know? So I don't want to like mislead people to think that this thing is
indestructible. That's just unrealistic. That, you know, I have some people like, oh, for the price, you think it would never break. And it's like, that's absurd. I don't care if you buy a Ferrari or a Kia. They both have to go to the shop for oil changes and repairs and maintenance. So that's one of the misconceptions that people have. Like, oh, if I spend more money, it's going to be perfect. No, if you spend more money, it's going to be better quality. And yes, like, these are the things that, you know, you pay for. This latch right here, for example, it's $25, right? It's a locking latch. This handle comes out of Germany. It was designed out of Germany. Super nice, you know, and you have this really nice cupboards and drawers with soft clothes. You don't get that in a $20,000 trailer, and they certainly don't lock. And when you're off-roading, the doors will open, things will fly out. You know, usually most trailers are using those 98-cent clip latches that shut the doors, and, you know, it doesn't hold up anything. Look up here. If you come up here, this is another perfect example, you know. You have dual gas shocks, right? You have piano hinges. I mean, some of these piano hinges in here are anywhere from $20 to $60, depending on the size. You know, and most trailers, I've gone to Home Depot to replace the latches. They're $2, right? And like, if you've ever seen those ones, little plastic dealios that go right here, and then there's a little pin that comes in and plops in, and the second you go anywhere, you know, down the road, they plop, they fall out, and they break. They're 98 cents. What do you expect? So those are the types of things. It's just like, you can't, you know, these lock completely in. And now you do have some good amount of storage space throughout here. These are super nice. This guy goes down here, and it is super deep, goes in all the way. Over here you have nice setup in here. This is your triple filtration system. Something new in the 2020s that the 2019s did not have is all of these bypasses. So now when you go to winterize it, you can turn off the water from flowing in, and you can bypass the whole system. In our customer only video library, we actually do have a winterizing video that explains how to winterize the entire trailer. It's like a 30-minute video. But we give that access to you when you put in an order. But I mean, so that's they've made that more convenient for the US market, which is super nice. They've also added this nice little guard right here. This is a mixer valve. This is what you'll find in boats, yachts. If you've ever been on a cruise ship, they have that. It adjusts and sets the temperature of the water, so it's always the same temperature, so you don't get scalding hot water. But they've also just covered this with a nice casing right there with black series on it. It used to be just kind of open, and you kind of saw all the stuff behind there. I mean, these right here are super nice. These little grommet dealios, I don't actually know what they're called, but, you know, they don't have to, you know, put the plumbing in here so nicely. Oh, look at this. I love this. This is new. This is actually on the 2020s. I've noticed that these brackets that they're holding now are rubber, right? So, because when you think about it, if this was just upheld by metal, you know, if you're going off-roading, bouncing around, potentially you could scratch it and it could break. They've done this rubber here, and look at the backing on this thing. They've put this whole rubber backing thing against the wall. And the reason why is when you're going off-roading, so it's not hitting against the wall and potentially breaking, they've actually put that nice rubber backing, so it's actually gonna hold up stronger. They've also updated some of the plumbing. There was some they used a different material on the actual drain. This is a heavier duty than what they had before. So lots of little improvements, lots of the things you wouldn't even notice. Look at this. I love this. This is the biggest piano hinge. There's like 30 screws right there, you know, and it's so funny. And people ask, well, why, what's the price? Why are they more expensive? And it's like, well, that piano hinge costs like $60. Opposed to two little hinges that cost $2, that, you know, two screws here, two screws here, two screws, you know, when you're driving and rattling, guess what? Two screws is going to unscrew itself over time. Even 30 screws will unscrew themselves over time. That's why I'm saying things aren't perfect, but that is going to hold up way more to anything else. I mean, like, you can actually put weight on this door and it doesn't rip off the cabinet door, which is incredible. So really, really, really nice. Really, really. Here you got your microwave. Now, this does work off-grid. Same with the TV. You have an inverter system. And I actually have a video where I explain power systems of most common trailers and the Black Series. The Black Series is built to be completely off-grid. Up on the roof, you saw there's 300 watts of solar. You also have an inverter system that takes the batteries and turns them into regular power, so you can run TVs, microwaves. Over at this plug, you can see it's labeled inverter right here. The plug behind the TV and the microwave is also an inverter plug. You also have an inverter plug over here by your bed, which is super nice. We could upgrade it and add it into a dual plug and put USB ports if you wanted to charge your cell phone. But you do also over here have a 12 volt plug and USB spots, and that gives it so you can actually charge your phone. So coming down over here, we have the table. Now this does fold down and turn into a bed. We have a video called "The Strongest Table Ever," because most trailers have those little poles and they just like they just rip out and they're so terrible. Actually, I did a side-by-side comparison with somebody, and the guy told me, oh yeah, when he bought his trailer, his dealer told him, never drive with the table up. You need to put it down, take the poles down, and put the table like on the ground or in the bed position. Otherwise, it could fall and break, right? We don't tell that to you, but because this table is actually super beefy, and it does have cushions that it comes with and turns us into a bed. But while we have this down, it's super easy to access what's underneath here, and I want to show you really quick. Underneath this is your PureSign 2000 watt inverter controller, charger system. So it's three things, a handful. I actually have a video explaining this more in depth. Look at the backing on this though. Suede backing. These are actually, what, 1/2 inch by 3 inch pieces of wood. You know, and this is about 1/4 inch thick. I have, like literally, I've seen trailers that are like, it's paneling. And these are like 1/2 inch by 1/2 inch or 1 inch, or you don't want to make it super big, then it's like heavy, as the trailer is already heavy. People complain about it being too heavy, but it's incredible. They do definitely use thicker, better materials than most trailers. Now coming over here, here's an update for you. Over on this side now, I have another cool update to show you. It is in the 2020s, the 2019s, had 2 batteries. The new 2020s, if you order now, are now coming officially with 4 100-amp-hour gel batteries. This is incredible. Oh my goodness. Come up here. I got to tell you something. We were at an RV show last week, and I had a couple in, and they were looking at this trailer, and then they got tricked to go over and look at some other trailers for a little while. Not really, but they were walking through and they saw another trailer, and it was like, I call it eye candy, right? It looked really cool and it looked pretty, right? And it was only 25,000, normally 30,000. They were doing a deal for 23 or 30, and they were like, oh, but it looks really pretty and it had a slide, and they're like, yeah, like, I don't know. And but the people want to go off grid, and they told me they're looking at this trailer, and the dealer told them it didn't come with batteries. And I was like I was not trying to be like mean or anything, but I was just like, I got thinking about it. I was like, doesn't come with batteries? That is like going to a dealership and buying a brand new car, and then the dealer saying, oh, by the way, it doesn't come with a battery. What? You can't start it and drive it home, right? Like, a trailer without a battery is useless, right? Like, it needs a battery. I mean, I was kind of thinking, that's like selling a remote control car to a kid without a battery. Yeah, but some things do say batteries not included. But I think it's worse than that. It's like buying a car without a battery. It doesn't start and drive. A trailer without a battery, that's absurd. So I don't think that's industry standard. I think that's probably why they're giving such a good deal at the show, is they're taking things off and then selling you them to put them back on, so it's not as good of a deal as you think it is. But regardless, I thought that was so absurd. But common industry practice is actually 1 battery. A lot of dealers know that 1 battery is terrible, and so what they'll do is throw on 2 batteries, or consumers will have to throw on 2 batteries, because 1 battery won't even run your furnace really for a night. If you're out camping somewhere cold and running your furnace, like, your battery could die before the morning, and then your LP, your gas propane detectors, they have special sensors that if the voltage gets too low, they start screaming at you, because it's like, hey, you don't want a dead battery. battery, because if the battery goes all the way dead and then there's a propane leak, you're going to die. You know, it's because I won't be able to alert you. So it starts freaking out and telling you your battery's getting low. And so I've had people like that have never owned a trailer, like their first time camping with one battery, they turn on the furnace in the middle of the night, everything starts screaming at them and they're like, what's going on? You know, because one battery's not enough. Zero batteries do you no good. One battery, not enough. Two batteries is like the golden standard, right? Most people will like add a second battery. Black Series stock, brand new 2020, comes with four batteries, which is incredible. And they're not lead acid wet batteries, they're gel batteries, which are better in colder temperature, they're better with solar. So super, super nice. That's a huge upgrade to the 2020s that people are getting now. Sorry, I get a little bit passionate and started going on a rant there for a second. But I want to show you the stovetop. This is super nice. I've never seen such a nice stovetop or oven combo in any trailer in America. This even has a nice little light that turns on in the oven, which is super nice. You have a sparker, an electric igniter that ignites these, but also ignites the oven. This is super cool. And I've never seen this on any trailer ever before. See, look, I'll show you. Boom. See that? And now you have, whoops, you got to hold it down for a second longer until the propane feeds it. You have an igniter in there. And I have never seen that on any trailer. Even $500,000 motorhomes, you usually have to get under there and use your little lighter. But super cool, and a little light too. Little nice towel rack, which is nice. Most trailers, they use just this towel rack here, and you know, and then it falls down. This actually is up higher, which is nice. Right over here, I wanna show you this. Once again, it's lockable. It comes up and out of the way. This slides all the way out. You can adjust it to a lower level if you want. These long cupboards are useless when you don't have stuff like that, which is super nice. Piano hinges, locking latches. Right here, here is your deep, useless, no, not really, drawer, as I just said, deep drawers are useless without a tray. But there's where you put your long cookie sheets, you know, and long stuff in there. Put the stuff you don't need as your Dutch oven in the back and your pots in the front or something. So when you need it, you don't use it as much, get it out, which is super nice. Over here, you have your water pumps. One of the things they've upgraded is the drinking water pump used to be half the size. They've upgraded it to a full size drinking water pump. These are actually bigger than most standard trailers. And you have a general and drinking water, which I told you I would explain to you more in detail when we got inside. Since we're inside, let's go up to the faucet on the kitchen. So super cool. I've never seen this in any trailer until we started carrying the Black Series. This right here, you can see there's two zones, and there's two actual spigots that turn these both on separately. So as you saw below, the filtration system. Oh, once again, you know, one of those trailers that was sitting next to us at the show at cost $125,000 had one single filter. This trailer, not $125,000, has three, a triple filtration system. And so that's what this little guy is right here. And what it does is it comes through and it comes out one zone. It has its own separate tank. And so the tank capacities are, you have two separate drinking water tanks that total are 66 gallons. With the water heater, you have 72 total water capacity on this trailer. So 72 gallons is a lot of water, right? For a trailer that's 26 feet long, that's a lot of water. The drinking water has a 16 gallon purified triple filtration system that goes through that one zone. And the general water tank that runs your shower, your flushes your toilet, runs this other spigot here, is 50 gallons. So what's really cool about this is the idea behind this is if you are off grid, you know, and you pulled up to a stream, you wanted to fill up your general water tank to say flush your toilet, shower. I personally, I've not done this, but the idea is that you could, and you would not contaminate your drinking water because it has its own separate tank, separate pump. Super cool. So come over here. I want to show you up above here, a nice counter space. I mean, if there was one thing I would like to see is maybe a solid surface eventually, maybe in the 2021 models or 22 or, but once again, it's weight, right? You, there's only so much weight, you know, we don't want to have to tow it with a semi truck, right? I mean, we can make it out of gold if you want. It would make it expensive and really heavy. Oh, I want to show this. This is a backsplash. This is super nice. So this is not just the wood. This is actually like a laminate backsplash, which is super nice. It's amazing how often, I mean, I have a, my previous motorhome, $80,000, no backsplash, right? You wash dishes, water guts on it, it's paper, it's sticker, it peels. Little details like that drive me crazy. Over here, let's step into this area. Most standard things, I have a video about this that I make fun of. Most trailers, it's like dots, right? This is actually gives you readouts. So currently we're using 14 amps. We're at 12.24 volts. Before the sun went down, we were at over 13 volts charging. You have your wattage and then your total battery life. So super cool to be able to really see what you're actually, what your battery is actually doing and when it's going to die or not die. And so that's the biggest thing that people replace as a new RV owner is batteries, because they don't properly maintain them. And you can't properly maintain a battery unless you can see what it's doing. Hey, here's a cool update that they've done on the this is on the from the 2019 to the 2020. Now, most people wouldn't know about this, but we do, because we modify these trailers like crazy, and my mechanics, they have to pull this panel out to install new like Victron solar controllers and new monitoring systems, and so he has to pull this out to run wires sometimes through here. And it's so funny, is the old ones in the 2019s, they were, you had to just pry off and they popped off and then you clip it back on. But guess what? Over time, that's going to lose its pliability or whatever, and it's going to get bad, and you're going to have to buy a new one. So these are nice, is because now you can just screw them on, and you can unscrew it. It's like, back over here for a second for another rant. Let's stay tuned. Going to break commercial for a rant by Shane Stauffer. So it, like, we have been carrying this product. We're one of the first dealers in the United States, and all I have seen is improvements. And that to me is such an important thing, because over the years of being in part of the RV industry, all I've seen is the opposite. You know, they make things lighter, cheaper. You know, I always say ultra light means ultra junk, right? Because that's what it is. Let's make it thinner. Let's make it cheaper. Like, not a lot of forethought towards like servicing, maintaining. You know, this is really cool, because guess what? If something does break behind you, something you do need a service, you don't have to rip and break things to get there. You just unscrew it and then you can get access to it. The details, those are details that you don't always see in trailers. And so I'm so impressed with Black Series. All I have seen is improvements. I've talked with the owner, I've talked with the GM, and either they're the greatest liars in the world or I'm just very gullible, but I believe them. You know, the GM, he tells me, he says, Shane, we want to be known for the best built trailer you can buy, period. We don't, when people think of our trailers, we want to be known for quality. And the only way, and they tell this to us, because they're like, whenever you find something that's broken or something that's not good or something that's, you know, let us know so we can improve it, because we don't want to be sending out stuff that's breaking all the time. So most of the problems that I'm seeing is usually user error. You know, people don't know how to work things and they break it. But I'm seeing Black Series always trying to improve it. So I'm super happy, and I hope it stays that way. Like I said, we've been with them for going on a couple of years, and hopefully that doesn't change. And all I've seen in it is improvement so far. So let's hope that continues. Double crossies. Right here, you got digital readouts. This is super nice. I just saw we had one of the tanks pulled apart, and those digital readouts, they're, you know, they're on these little sliders that go up and down to get you the reading, which is super cool. I've never seen it until today, actually, because they were pulling apart and doing a winter package. Over here, you have water heaters, you have electricity, you have propane. You also have breaker fuses. This is another thing that drives me crazy about the American market, is they use automotive fuses, the little ones that blow up. And if you're new to an RV, you're new to the RV world or trailer world, you have to carry a box of fuses, because if one goes out, you got to go and pull your tweezers and pull it out. This, you just press the button and you're good to go. You have your separate independent pumps, switches that turns everything on. Really, really nice. Moving over to the fridge, I don't know if you've ever seen these Dometic fridges. Sometimes they have this really cheap handle that you gotta like push in and pull. These are actually really nice. I've never seen these on a Dometic fridge before. And that is also an upgrade from the 2019s to the 2020s. I don't know if Black Series just wanted to get the better handles, but they are nice. Over here, you have a fridge. It works off of both electricity, which is 120, or propane. It's a very large fridge. These are all adjustable. Fridge freezer combo. These work really great. I love the propane. I know some hardcore off-road people like the 12 volt. I think the propane's way more efficient. But I mean, there's arguments for both sides for sure. The 12 volts nice, but this is a two-way, which is 120 and propane. Up here we have our air conditioning unit. A lot of people are always asking, what kind of heater does it have? Now this does have two heaters. One of the heaters for your off-grid is your propane heater, and that works. That comes right out of there, and which I got to show you a cool update on that in just a second. And then you have your air conditioning, which is a 13,500 BTU Dometic AC unit. Works great. Gets this really nice and cold. This is not a huge box. You know, we're just over 20 feet. The actual box itself, it keeps it really cool with the dual pane windows, with the insulation in the ceiling and everything. It stays pretty cool. This also duals as a heater. So if you are plugged in, if you are pulling through a campground, you can run the heater also up here. Or you can run the furnace with the propane, which is nice. And that's more for off-grid use. Some more extra storage here. But as I said, I want to show you an update to the 2020s right over here as you come this way. Over here, one of the updates is the furnace. They've actually moved the thermostat up higher, and the trailer gets better distribution of heat. I'm currently sitting in single digits, and it does. I can tell you that for sure. It used to be down over here on the 2019 models, and the furnace would just heat it up and turn it off way too soon. Really nice that they moved it up there. They've also added a tank heater pad. This does not work off-grid. It only works off of shore power. Same with this plug that's not wired into the inverter. Now, we do have a modification where we can wire everything into the inverter, so everything works off-grid, but most everything works off-grid on this unit, and really indefinitely. I mean, with four batteries, 300 watts of solar, it's a very, very robust system. I mean, most typical trailers, you know, doesn't matter the price you're paying, people going out and buying really nice high-end trailers for $100,000, they don't usually come equipped with any solar, and well, hopefully more than zero batteries, one or two batteries. So with the 400 amp hour battery system with the 300 watts, it's a very robust system. Everything can always be upgraded. We add extra solar panels all the time for our customers, but I don't feel, it depends on the user, right? Depends on how much you watch TV or how often you run the microwave. If you have a coffee pot that you drink coffee all day long, I don't know, you know, so it's always dependent upon the user. But my personal usage, I've been out camping and I've never experienced needing more power. I feel like the power has always been sufficient, you know, but if you ever get caught in, you know, really cloudy for a long time, you could potentially need more power. Now, since we're right here, let's look up here. This is the, I don't know what to call this, the porthole, goes up, opens up, which is super nice. If you want to have it in a partial setting position, you can bring it to right here. And then these little guys latch it and lock it in a halfway setting. If you want to leave it open and not have bugs come in, you have a screen and that actually locks in right there. Or if you're getting ready to go to bed, you probably want to close it. Don't open this up in high winds. and then if you want to go to bed, you can close this and lock it off. And then that's your blackout shade. And then of course, turn off your lights. No one has ever complained about this trailer not having enough lights, because you have windows, you have tons of LED lights, and they're all LED, so they're super high, they're good efficient. Nobody's ever complained about the lighting. It's very, very good lighting. But now we're gonna head back. Another thing that nobody's ever complained about in the HQ19 is the bathroom. So I'm gonna show you the bathroom, but as we're walking back to the bathroom, I do wanna show you a cool little feature. This comes up, and this is a footrest, and it's
sometimes those get stuck, but they're usually come up right there, flip up, and then there's two little buttons here that you can press, and then that goes down nicely. So super cool.
Coming into the bathroom. Maybe I'll take a seat first. Oh, so this is a porcelain toilet, which is super nice.
That's the sound of porcelain, just so you know.
I am a pretty big guy. This is pretty comfortable in here. This door also does shut. Oh, let me show you this actually. Come around here, and this latch right here shuts. And when you shut this off, you have a little bit more shoulder width. I am very broad-shouldered, and I feel like it's comfortable. And then this also locks, so nobody can come in. When you're off-roading, make sure you lock this, always. You do have vents. You have little vents right there. You also have little lights. This opens up. This isn't the best vent ever. We do have, like, we've been installing a lot of fantastic vent fans for people, or max flow vents. But you also have all the same features, windows in here. This is a new update, your toilet paper holder. I know it is behind your back, but I just say, you know, just pull it off and set it when you're doing your stuff, and when you're done, put it back on. At least they added it, which is nice. Over here, this is a washing machine, which is cool. If you don't think it's cool, we can remove it for you and you could use it as storage. Right here, this is so nice. This is a porcelain sink. Super, super nice, right? And then metal water fixtures. Very modern, very nice. Over here you have this is new to the 2020s also. Little vanity mirror, the close-up ones, so really nice. You also have little lights in here, touch lights. You also back up a little bit and you can see your mood lights right here. You can have your main lights right there. You have tons and tons of storage. We have measurements of this storage space on our website. So if you're curious on what that is, and everything is the same quality. This is what's really incredible, is I've noticed a lot of trailers, like, what you see is quality, but when you get back into, like, the hidden areas, right, you start seeing them, they start getting cheap. I mean, okay, listen, 2 gas struts, I kind of feel like that might be too much. I think 1 would do the job, but Black Series is not there. Where they skimp is the vents, right? But not on the hinges, not on the lockable things. Nice soft close, so you can't slam it, and everything's lockable. Lots of storage right here. You come into here, everything's nice tucked up against the wall. They've put these nice little things around here just so things aren't banging against the wood. A little bit of storage in there too, and lockable. This is another update to the 2020s. And that's magnetic. It's magnetic, in case you didn't hear that. The old one was like this bifolding door that would come out and it would pop out right here. And so you, like, if you were just using the sink, you would run into it. So it's super nice that they did this. Also, the old one had some problems with water leaking out of it. And so this seems to be a lot better. Lots of people like it. This is a huge shower. And this is all one piece molded fiberglass, right? My $80,000 trailer had a piece of plastic and there was like screws, and then they put little grommets over to cover the screws, right? This is beautiful. You have a little soap dish holder here that moves up and down. You got this guy that moves up and down. You know, you can shower comfortably in here. And like I said, I'm a big guy, 6 feet, and too heavy, over 200 and 60. But if I drop a bar of soap, look, I can pick it up. There you go. There's a good example. Next time that won't be as impressive, is because I'm on a diet. but yeah, there you go. I mean, I think I feel like I touched everything. Well, one of the things that I forgot is the chassis. It's hot dipped galvanized steel. Now, if you don't know what that is,
maybe do some research. I didn't study metallurgy. I didn't even like chemistry growing up. I had a hard time with it. But essentially, what it is there's a molten bath of zinc, right? And they take the steel, they dip it in, and it becomes essentially a layer. It's not like paint or like a rhino coating or whatever. It's actually like adheres to the steel, and it prevents it from corroding, and it prevents the rust, right? And most trailers are gonna be an I-beam with paint or some powder coating. You scratch it, paint pills. It takes maintenance. It requires upkeep. The galvanized, typically they say, will last 50 years in the harshest climates. You know, that's like on the beach in ski resorts. If you've ever seen freeway signs, they're galvanized, right? Because it has a long life. Even in the less harsher climates, they say it will last over 100 years. And that's incredible, because steel, if you throw a piece of steel in your backyard, in 50 years, it's dirt. It decomposes and turns back to dirt. Galvanized steel in 50 years will still be structurally strong in the harshest climates. And I hear people saying, oh, my dream is to go out on the beach and park. And growing up, my parents, we actually lived on the beach while we were building a house in our trailer in California. And we, you know, within just a few months, I'm going to sit down and relax right here for a second. In just a few months of living on the beach, we had rust. You know, it was everywhere, and you can sand it, you can scrape it and try to clean it up, but it becomes so difficult. It's like cancer, you know, it just grows everywhere, right? So it's funny, I've had some people say, man, I'll just put bigger, you know, just upgrade my suspension, you know, and then I don't have to spend as much money on the trailer. And I'm like, no, that's crazy. That's like saying, you know, I'm going to put big tires on a Geo Metro and it's going to be a rock crawler like a Jeep Rubicon. You know, it's like, that's absurd, right? There's no way. I don't care how big a tires you put on a Geo Metro. It's not going to be a Rubicon or an Earth Roamer or, you know, a military vehicle, right? And it's not just the suspension, right? It's the foundation, right? Starting from hot dipped galvanized steel to aluminum composite to an aluminum roof, right? And like I said, earlier, aluminum is 200 to 500 years, right? It's all of the materials that are from the ground to the very tippy top of the roof are better, right? And it's like I always say, the foundation, you know, it's important, the foundation, you know, when the winds come and the floods beat against it, you know, if you have a bad foundation, everything just, it crumbles and falls apart, right? And so, you know, the Black Series from the very ground down, from the ground up, is it's better material. Not everything. Like I said, I'm not a huge fan of these. The decals, I would rather be paint, you know, but, you know, it is an aluminum structure, right? So, yeah, if you have to repaint it in 5 or 10 years, whoop-de-doo, right? It's like, but the difference is like a rubber roof on most trailers that you get, and it doesn't matter the brand besides Airstream, right? Every other brand out there that's supposedly a good brand, you know, they use rubber. I don't like to trash on trailers. Like, I'm sick of the U.S. industry, honestly, being so cheap. Because I've seen it get cheaper over the years. Like post-recession, prior to the recession, trailers actually were built better. I saw that. I grew up in the industry. You know, the people that weathered through the recession, they did it by making things cheaper, right? But now here we are post-recession. Let's go back to quality. Let's get things better again. But they're not. They figured out, oh, we can make it cheap and light and use, you know, instead of half inch, quarter inch, instead of 1 inch, you know, half inch, we can get everything cheaper and lighter. We can go to, you know, and we can still make the same price, right? And that to me is, it's not, well, us as the industry, as the consumers, if we keep on buying it, guess what? They'll keep on making it. I believe that. I'm so excited about Black Series because I don't just think it's a better trailer. I think it's an industry changer. I think that, you know, as people start seeing these trailers in the market, the American industry is going to have to step up and make better stuff. Is because, you know, but we we have to stop buying it, right? right? We got to start, you know, demanding, you know, make it better. And this is kind of what happened, I feel like, in, you know, in the past with Honda and Toyota, right? They came in and just were making such a better product. I believe that the U.S. market has stepped up. I love all the American brands now, you know, the Fords and Chevys, and I think they're just as good, you know, in some instances better, especially the trucks, right? But you know, it took them losing part of the market to actually start making things better, right? And I really am excited about this product. If you can't tell, it's really, to me, a game changer product. And I also love the outdoors. I love nature and I love getting out there. And there's nothing on the market that quite does it like a Black Series. I mean, they're not just extremely built well, but they're also like they're capable. Right? To be off-grid, to go places that no other trailer can go. And that's what I really love about them and am super excited. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, I know this was a very long video. Don't forget, if you're actually interested in buying one of these trailers, we should be the only dealer you are talking to, because we know these trailers. We're passionate about these trailers. We know how to service these trailers. We give better technical support on these trailers than anywhere else. Because like I said, like, things will break. It's nothing's immune from that, right? But when that happens, you want a dealer that actually understands the product, that's hands-on, that, you know, we can answer, this is how you fix it over the phone, because we actually are users of the product. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, do all those good things, and make some comments if you have more questions. We'd love to answer them. Make it a beautiful day. See you soon.